For 8 years, we watched Malia and Sasha Obama grow up in the White House, and let's just say it wasn't always easy, even if they managed to stay out of trouble. But after watching Michelle Obama's Netflix documentary, Becoming, we're finally getting a glimpse into how much life has changed for these two.
Being able to let all of that leave your mind creates so much more space.
They had a pretty normal life. Sasha was only 7 years old and Malia was 10 when their father, Barack Obama, was first elected into office. Now, some people might assume that being the daughters of one of the most powerful world leaders came with certain advantages. After all, who needs to clean up after themselves when they've got maids and butlers to tend to their every need? But it turns out that the girls didn't have free rein to do whatever they wanted. Barack and Michelle wanted to give their daughters somewhat of a normal upbringing, which meant that in the Obama household, Sasha and Malia had responsibilities just like every other kid in the world. They had a bedtime curfew, which was 8 p.m., and that's just one of the ways the president and his wife gave their daughter some sense of normalcy. And while some might say that the girls should have been allowed to enjoy their White House privileges, there was a reason why their parents were so strict with them. There were rules in place. Barack and Michelle wanted to give Sasha and Malia a stable childhood, but that wasn't easy since they were one of the most famous families in the world. In 2018, Michelle told Today that she wanted her daughters to experience the ups and downs of growing up, but she wanted them to face these things in private.
We tried to set up boundaries around their exposure.
And the only way to do that was to keep them out of the spotlight as much as possible. And there were rules they had to follow too. Michelle begged the housekeepers to not clean their rooms for them. She told Today, "These girls need to learn how to clean their own rooms and make their beds and do their laundry. You cannot do this every day because they will not live here forever." She wanted Sasha and Malia to be independent and self-reliant. She didn't want them to grow up not knowing how to do basic things for themselves like making their own beds. Someday the girls would go to college and wouldn't have servants to rely on. But Sasha and Malia weren't the only ones that had to follow rules. Michelle changed the White House butler's dress code so that her daughters wouldn't grow up thinking that African-American men dressed in tuxedos and served people. And according to the New York Daily News, Sasha couldn't watch television or use the computer on weekdays unless she had to do research for homework. She also ate dinner with her family at 6:30 and took piano lessons. And while they had family dinner together, the blinds had to be down for security reasons. But that didn't mean she couldn't do normal things like any girl her age, like hang out at the mall with her friends and watch movies. However, there's one thing the girls didn't get every year, and it was birthday presents. But there was a reason for that. Michelle and Barack wanted to teach them some limits, so instead of presents, they got birthday parties, movie tickets, pizza, and popcorn. Oh, and if you're wondering if the girls had an allowance, well, they did. The girls received just $1 a week, as long as they did their chores like washing the dishes and setting the table. But now the girls are all grown up and things have changed a lot. The girls are living their own lives now. The Obamas did a great job shielding their daughters from the press while they were growing up. With the exception of the occasional state dinner or the annual turkey pardon, they were rarely talked about, seen, or heard. But that all changed. The former first daughters are now living their new lives as regular citizens, and their parents couldn't be prouder. Sasha's 18 and a freshman at the non-Ivy League University of Michigan, while Malia is 21 and a junior at Harvard, where her parents went to law school. Gone are the days when Sasha and Malia had armed guards with them when they had a sleepover at a friend's house. But now that they're out of the White House, are they really riding solo at their respective universities? According to their official website, the Secret Service offers lifetime protection for all former presidents. But children of former presidents only get protection up to the age of 16. Despite the rumors that security is still hovering over the girls, Sasha and Malia have managed to lead normal lives while they continue their higher education. But studying isn't the only thing these gals started doing after mom and dad left the White House. Malia's life after the White House. Although 2017 was the end of Obama's term in office, his daughter Malia had jumped ship in the fall of that year, but she didn't exactly jump into Harvard right away. Malia took a gap year and even did an internship for the Weinstein Company. She spent a lot of time reading through scripts and picking out the ones that were worthy of going to production. Her interest in this particular internship was inspired by the fact that Malia is an aspiring filmmaker. In fact, in 2015, she visited New York University, which has one of the best film programs in the nation. But she eventually decided to go to Harvard. As with most girls her age, education wasn't her only priority. After enrolling into Harvard, Malia started getting closer to her classmates, and a couple of months later, she was photographed kissing a mystery man at a Harvard versus Yale football game in 2017. That was the year she allegedly met Rory Farquharson, a UK citizen who is now studying law in Harvard. According to sources, the former first daughter spent time with this rich family in the UK. But how rich are the Farquharsons? Well, according to The Tab, Rory's father is the CEO of Insight Investment Management Limited. And they seem to have a lot in common. Rory's second cousin, Andrew Farquharson, was once a courtier to the Queen and later became master of the household at Buckingham Palace until 2009. But despite the rumors that Malia and Rory have split up, they seem to be very much in love. But what has Malia's younger sister been up to all these years? Sasha's life after the White House. Before her dad became president, Sasha and her sister Malia went to a progressive private school called the University of Chicago Laboratory School. During that time, Sasha was involved in a lot of extracurricular activities like tennis, piano, and gymnastics. But when the Obamas moved to Washington, D.C., Sasha and Malia had to switch to another private school called Sidwell Friends School. This was the same school former first daughter Chelsea Clinton went to when her father, Bill, was in office. But life wasn't all about studying and having responsibilities. It turns out that Sasha knew how to have fun, too. In January of 2017, she went on a girls' trip to Miami Beach with a couple of close friends, including Joe Biden's granddaughter, Maisie Biden. Sasha reportedly went out dancing and ate desserts at local restaurants while she was there. Then, a few months later, she and her big sister Malia went on a familycation to Bali with their parents. While they were there, Sasha visited the UNESCO World Heritage Site Jatilawa Village, and also went whitewater rafting on the Ying River. And proving that she was the coolest teen around, a 16-year-old Sasha went backstage and hung out with Cardi B and Offset at DC's 6th annual Broccoli City Festival in 2018. She went on to graduate from Sidwell Friends School in 2019, which paved the way towards a higher learning opportunity at the University of Michigan. While she could have gone to Harvard like her sister, Sasha didn't want to follow in anyone else's footsteps. But recently, a Netflix documentary has given the girls a chance to speak up publicly for the first time in 10 years. Bullying and rumors hit really low. The 2020 Netflix documentary Becoming offers a better look at Michelle Obama's book by the same name. It highlights her hopes and dreams and what life is like now that she's starting a whole new chapter.
It's not going back, it's not, you know, it's just all different, and it's different forever.
In the documentary, Michelle takes us on a behind-the-scenes look into her personal life while also talking to Stephen Colbert and Gayle King about the strict rules her daughters had growing up. Sasha and Malia made a rare appearance in the documentary to talk about life after the White House, and they caused quite a storm. People loved seeing candid moments of the girls and Michelle talking about their life. But social media can be really cruel sometimes. Instead of getting to know these young women a little better, some online haters took jabs at Malia on Twitter and mocked the shape of her head. Fortunately, other Twitter users came to her defense and told the Billies to stop the hate. Of course, this wasn't the only time the internet had given Malia a headache. She allegedly doesn't have a social media account, and if she does, it's obviously kept away from the public eye. But a fake Facebook page claiming to belong to Malia was allegedly throwing shade at President Trump. Strange rumors have followed the former first daughter for years. There was even a satirical website called dailyworldupdate.us that claimed Malia had been arrested at Harvard, which obviously turned out to be false. But there was an incident at a comedy club, The Comedy Studio, where comedian Pete Holmes claims he had a falling out with Malia. According to Cheat Sheet, Holmes went on Conan's talk show and told him that when it was his turn to go on stage for a stand-up show, he noticed that a girl and her friend were giggling and whispering, and they were distracting him, so he called them out on it and told them to be quiet. When they didn't, he covered them with the curtain. But of course, the audience didn't laugh, and he later learned why.
After the show, I find out it was Obama's daughter.
No!
But Malia's not the kind of girl who would let an incident like this get the best of her. They're super confident women. Over the years, Sasha and Malia have gone from being two little girls who wore sweet dresses, preppy cardigans, and sweaters to confident women with their own sense of style and unique voice. But even when they wore their parents' approved wardrobe, you could see that the girls were pretty different. And now, thanks to the documentary, we can see how their fashion choices mark the beginning of a new era. The girls are redefining who they are and finding themselves at the same time. Malia often went for classic prints like stripes and plaids, but Sasha opted for vibrant and bold colored gold and maroon outfits. But now the former first daughters are letting their hair down and having fun with their looks. While Sasha wore an Aaliyah graphic t-shirt and distressed jeans, Malia sported a casual but chic peach v-neck shirt and light wash jeans. During the documentary, the sisters also shared their admiration for their mother, who's a prime example of the strong women they want to become.
Because I think that's the most important thing for a human to do, is to be proud of themselves.
The documentary offers a glimpse into Sasha and Malia's new life, and we're excited to see them grow up again, this time under their own terms. What did you think of the Netflix documentary Becoming? Are you excited to see where Sasha and Malia's lives take them? Let us know what you think in the comment section below. While you're there, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more great videos. Thanks for stopping by the Taco, and we'll see you next time.